Hello, everybody. I'm Pastor Kevin, and welcome to another great day at Hope Kids Online. I'm so glad that you're here with us today as we continue to take a closer look at our life app, Faith. Faith is trusting in what you can't see because of what you can see. Maybe it seems strange to trust in something that you can't see, but actually, we do it all the time. Let me show you. Everyone stand up. Go ahead, stand up. Okay, now on the count of three, everyone jump. Are you ready? One, two, three, jump. All right, have a seat. Now let me ask you something. When you jumped just now, did anyone worry that they would keep going and float through space without ever coming back down to the ground? No, of course not, because we can trust that gravity will keep us on the ground. We can't see gravity, but we sure would notice it if people started randomly floating into the air. Having faith in God is kind of like that too. Maybe we can't see God with our eyes, but when we focus on the things that He's done in our lives and the lives of the other people, that can help us put our trust in Him. Now let's check in with Dylan with another awesome episode of HKGN.
Hello everyone, and welcome to another great week at HKGN. I'm Dylan Foley, and I look forward to bringing you the good news today. In our first story, Thrivent, a local Lutheran financial organization, is hosting a fundraiser where all you have to do is color and share your artwork. For every picture shared on their Facebook page, they will donate $5 to Furnishing Dignity, which is an amazing organization that provides furniture to those who are transitioning from homelessness or foster care. Please contact Kevin for more information on how to participate or check out the Hope Lutheran Kids Facebook page. What a great way to help raise money for an important cause. Now let's check in with Sam with the weather. Sam, how's the weather?
Too hot outside.
Thank you, Sam. At Hope Kids, we know that everyone can connect with God and worship Him in many different ways. So many people feel connected to God through His creation. So we love to see our Hope Kids families and volunteers outside and enjoying the beautiful nature that He has created. If you haven't spent time in nature lately, we would encourage you to get out there and marvel at the beauty of His creation. Last but certainly not least, we wanted to spotlight one of our Hope Kids moms, Electra, who is a local basketball coach. Some of her past players reached out to her because they were going to get together to play and they wanted their coach to come and watch. We love this story because it shows that ministry and its impact to the youth in our community can happen anywhere, not just inside our church doors. Great job showing your students how much they matter to you, Electra. Thank you for joining us for another amazing week at Hope Kids Good News. Now get out there and be the good news in the world. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, Dylan. That is some good news. Hey, I've got a great game about focusing for us to play today. It's called Lost in the Details. We'll put a picture up on the screen for 15 seconds. You'll need to study it closely to make sure that you know all the details in the image. I mean every little detail. Then we'll show a slightly different version of that same picture. You'll have 15 more seconds to find the tiny little detail that's different from the version that was on the screen before. Are you ready? Here we go. Great job, everyone. You sure are good at focusing on the tiniest of details. Now let's get ready to sing and worship God together.
You were more beautiful than anyone ever. Every day you're the same, you never change, no, never. You were more beautiful than anyone ever. Every day you're the same, you never change, no, never. If I could I ever deny the love of my Savior, you brought to me everything, all I need forever. How could you be so good? There is no one like you. There has never, ever been anyone like you. You're so astounding. How could you be so good to me? Eternally, I believe.
Have you ever met someone and thought you knew what they were like, and then you discovered there was so much more to them than you ever realized? I know I have. People are always surprising me. It can be so easy for us to think we know people without really getting to know them. Well, one of Jesus's followers named Peter discovered that in a big way. We finish this month in Acts 10 as we pick up Peter's story. Through a pretty crazy dream and encounter with a non-Jewish follower of Jesus, Peter learns that the message of Jesus is for everyone. Peter had to change his mind about the Gentiles because God was now including them in what he was doing in the world through Jesus. Check out that and more in today's true story from the Bible.
The Bible, It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Acts, chapter 10.
As the early church grew, Peter traveled from town to town telling people the great news about Jesus and how he healed sick people. Now in Jaffa, he raised a dead woman back to life through the power of God's Spirit.
Tabitha, get up.
Many people in Joppa became believers, so Peter stayed there with a man named Simon, a leather worker who lived right beside the sea. Peter often went up to the roof to pray.
Ah, this is the life. Thank you, Lord, for all these fellow Jews believing in Jesus.
But God's plan was bigger than Peter imagined. About 40 miles north, a Roman army commander named Cornelius was praying too.
Lord, thank you for all you've given to me and my family.
Though Cornelius was not Jewish, him and his family worshiped God. They freely gave to anyone who needed help. While Cornelius was praying, God sent an angel in a vision.
Cornelius!
The angel's power and brilliance was so strong, Cornelius fell back in awe.
What is it, Lord?
Your prayers and gifts to poor people are like an offering to God. So he has remembered you. Now send men to Joppa. Have them bring back a man named Peter. He is staying with Simon by the sea.
Yes, Lord.
The angel vanished. Then Cornelius leapt from his feet. He called on two of his servants and a trusted soldier and told them everything.
Leave at once for Joppa.
Sir, yes, sir.
The trio left around 3 o'clock. Marching at top speed. Around noon the next day, they neared Joppa. At Simon's home, Peter had climbed up the roof to pray.
Lord, you've done amazing things here in Joppa. What's next? Lunch is next, I guess.
While lunch was being prepared, Peter continued to pray. And God sent him a vision, but it wasn't an angel.
What is happening?
It appeared to Peter that something like a large sheet was dropping from heaven. It contained a zoo of animals, pigs and camels, rabbits and birds and reptiles.
Get up, Peter. Kill and eat.
Peter stared in shock. The Jews were forbidden to eat the meats of these animals, which were called unclean.
No, Lord, I will not. I have never eaten anything that is not pure and clean.
Do not say anything is not pure that God has made clean.
Two more times, the same thing happened. Then the sheet was taken back up to heaven. Peter blinked and looked around.
What does it all mean?
At that very moment, the men sent by Cornelius arrived at Simon's front door. Is there a Peter staying here? Up on the roof, God's Spirit spoke to Peter.
Three men are looking for you. Get up and go downstairs. Don't let anything keep you from going with them. I have sent them.
Still, overwhelmed by his vision, Peter hurried down the steps, ran out the front door, where he found the men.
I'm the one you're looking for. Why have you come?
Sir, we have come from Cornelius, the Roman commander. He's a good man who worships God. The angel told him to invite you to his house so Cornelius can hear what you have to say.
Go to his house?
Just as it was forbidden for Jews to eat certain foods, it was also forbidden for Jews to enter the home of non-Jews.
Oh!
In that moment, Peter understood his vision. God was making a new rule about what was clean. The story of Jesus was not just for Jewish people, but for everyone.
Please, come in. We'll leave first thing in the morning.
The next day, Peter and the three men set out, along with some of the believers from Joppa. The following day, they arrived at Caesarea. This is the home of Commander Cornelius, sir.
Thank you.
Peter must have paused for a moment before he entered the house. Though God had told him to come, he had never entered the house of a non-Jewish person.
Here goes.
At the home, Cornelius had gathered all his relatives and friends to listen to Peter.
Greetings, Peter. We are honored you've come.
The commander lowered himself before Peter, showing a sign of deep respect.
Stand up. I am only a man myself.
As Cornelius stood, Peter surveyed the room before him. He took a deep breath.
You know that it is against our law for a Jew to enter the home of someone who isn't a Jew, but God has shown me that I should not say anyone is not pure and clean. May I ask why you sent for me?
Cornelius had explained everything the angel had told him, and Peter shared how God sent Jesus here to share God's love, how Jesus taught and healed people through God's power. Then he would be killed. But then God would raise him back to life again.
We ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people. All who believe in Jesus have their sins forgiven through his name.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
Glory to God.
Before Peter could finish speaking, God sent his Holy Spirit down to be with Cornelius and his family and friends. The Jewish believers who came with Peter, they stared in amazement.
But they're not Jews.
Surely no one can keep these people from being baptized with water. They have received the Holy Spirit just as we have.
Peter baptized Cornelius and his friends and family in the name of Jesus. He stayed with them for several days, overjoyed by the new perspective God had given.
God told Peter that he should give others a chance. He wanted Peter to reach out to Cornelius and his family, even though they didn't come from the same background. Because Peter did, Cornelius and his whole household put their faith in Jesus. If you think about it, the reason that we know about Jesus today is because someone told us. God wants all people to know him. His rescue plan is for all of us. Our faith is in Jesus, and it helps us to focus on others. It helps us share God's love with everyone we meet. Here's the thing. God wants us to love all people, even if they're different from us. Some people might talk differently than you do. They might be different in things that they do. They might even look different from you. None of that means that you can't like them. When we know Jesus, that means we should show love to everyone around us, not just the people who are most like us. Because knowing Jesus changes the way you see others. I want to thank you again for joining us this week. Please remember to share this with your friends, as Jesus' message is for everybody. And remember to check out what we have to offer throughout the week by following us at Hope Kids on Instagram at Hope Kids Palm Desert or Facebook at Hope Kids at Hope Lutheran. If you're in need of any prayer or support, I would love to be here for you, and you can reach out to me at kevin@hopepe.org. Otherwise, let's pray. Dear God, thank you for today. Thank you for loving us and everybody in this world. Give us your eyes so that we can see people in a different light, knowing that even though they're different, we can love everyone. Jesus, we thank you and we love you. In your name we pray. Amen. Have a great week.